Welcome to one of the cornerstone cities for the MFL, Grim Bay, Wisconsin, home of the Attackers.
Also home of the first semi-successful head transplant, Grim.
Yeah, whatever happened to that poor guy?
Well, he did all right for himself. He's the state mascot for head cheese.
This game is going to be a wholesale slaughter. No discounts in the MFL. The teams storm the field. The Motor City Maniacs battle the Grim Bay Attackers. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzro here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Paper, I scared a civil. I don't have an old son.
If the sound of a torn Achilles followed by laughter and taunting brings a smile to your face, you are tuned to the right place. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzro and the MFL crew is coming to you live on game day. Bricks, any thoughts on today's game?
I thought I had one, but I think I might have forgotten it. I remember. I forgot who's playing today.
Careful what you asked for, Grim.
Mistake there, thrown into tight coverage. The result is an interception. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math. You gotta be fucking kidding me. If that's a penalty, they should come up here and penalize us too.
Hey, don't give these refs any ideas, you idiot. Grim, hide the stash.
On it. And it's first and ten. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho-ho, crowd's loving it. And it's first and ten. And he breaks away. And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and ten. And another interception. This boom. Defense just called a time warp dirty trick. And now it's like everything that just happened didn't.
Get Brick's mom on the phone quick. I want to use 13,000 of those time warps and undo a mistake she did about 35 years ago.
The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
First and four. And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Touchdown! Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and ten. I hope you covered your ears, Briggs, because that was a sonic blast. He is fighting for every yard. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And It's first and 10.
You can't keep a good mutant.
They pick up 3 on a short pass. Second down and 7. This is your brain, and this is your brain on Brazil. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
The 30. The 20. The 10. Touchdown! And he rips off a game-breaking run for the score.
Is that right, Glenn? That penalty makes no sense.
Hey, something ain't kosher here, and I'm not talking about the corned beef with extra mayo. First and 10. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10. Left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
Third and 2. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. This guy's a brick shithouse. First and 10. And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
And that'll bring up second and 1. First and 10. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about sharing when he was... Oh, look at this guy break tackle.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second down and 5. And with another pick, the QB says, I don't always throw interceptions, but when I do, it's when the game is on the line. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300.
And that is unfortunate. And it's first and 10. I'm not sure who he was throwing to on that play. Second down and 10. And they run it for a couple of yards. Third down and 8. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new...
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
First and 10. Second down in a very lot. Nice run for 5 yards. And that'll bring up third down and 7. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
Hey, the donkey.
Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
And it's first and 10. Oh, what a brutal hit. A run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Second down and 10. I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of one. Second down and 10. Didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Third down and 10. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. A misfired punt will give the opposing team. They let the punt drop and it will be down by the defense. And it's first and 10. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and 3. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
First and 10. That's a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. And he held on to that one for a first down. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Well, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort. And he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second down and 10.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my...
Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. First and 4. Stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more!
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Second down and more than the QB would like. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim.
First and 8 to go. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
Yeah, big deal. Missed a meat for brain ran with a ball and didn't fall down.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. Did your mother ever tell you don't run with a chainsaw? And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Glenn, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently. 2nd and 3. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep, 3rd grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And it's 1st and 10. Blew up and he's on fire. I'm not talking about one of those video game Oh, the defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's 1st and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and 9. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Oh, with the brutal hit.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
It's 1st and 10. Four yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're at.
And he takes a timeout here. They have 2 left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
Was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim.
The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. 3rd and 4. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that's it. That's the last time out. It's score or die from here out. And it's 1st and 10. And the ball falls to the ground. That's incomplete.
He needs to throw it when a receiver can catch it. What's he doing?
And groundbreaking analysis as always there, Bricks.
Well, thank you. I do my part.
2nd down and 10. And he punched his way out of that tack. Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut and you'll tire these guys out. 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. He refuses to go down. And there's an 8-yard catch.
Chipping away with those medium passes. I like it. Like a patient prison break.
And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's Matt's stupsing time.
Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's 1st and 10. When defensive players go berserk, they've been known to rip the heads off. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? Oh, with the punishing hit. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all, Grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. The teams line up for the kickoff to start the second half. These guys will have to play a lot harder to make it a game. Well, either that or kill and cheat more. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and 5. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bert. And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appears to be cheating. He's just making shit up. And it's first and 10. Defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
And that'll be second and 8 to go. Defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Third down and 8. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. First down and 1. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turd. Another bullshit penalty. How long are these guys going to take this? Second down and a lot, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. It appears that the last ref was calling his stockbroker during the huddle, and that tipped him off.
Yeah.
Looks like he won't be buying that boat anytime soon, huh? Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Oh, man, what a throw. Come on, man, you gotta catch that.
I don't catch anything, Grim. I'm retired.
Third down and forever. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt. But he seems to have worked through it.
And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. First down. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, I love this dirty trick. The quarterback, he scores! He earned those points on the heels of an epic run.
Don't call things epic, Grim. Kids aren't going to think you're cool no matter what you do.
Junior, I don't want kids to think I'm cool. You know, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Briggs. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And it's first and 10. And he just slipped away like a greased pig. And he picks up about 6 on the play. Be second down and 4. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
Boom to the moon! Another loser. loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Brain or a nervous system, but I see your point, Bricks. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Oh, he just got crushed. And it's first and 10. Catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. First and 10. He picks up 8 yards on that pass. Second down and 2. Well, that play didn't work. He'll have to rethink that. Third and 2. Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
He's got the distance, and the kick is good. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And his back, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. It's first and 10. And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. Second down and long.
Oh my gosh, the defense is playing.
And the defense gets another pick. Man, rough day.
Mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
Oh, nice time warp dirty trick called by the D, and the offense is pissed. Oh, for you kids at home, that's how you play mutant football.
Hey, wait a minute. What the? Didn't they just... am I losing my mind? Or did that play that I saw just not happen? I gotta stop smoking them untidy laundry pods.
Does the QB know which team he's on? Oh, with the brain scrambler. It's first and 10. He zings it in there for a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. Oh, nice hit. It's first and 10. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the deep pow. And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. Done for a first down. And it's first and 10. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. And it's first and 10. You know, a lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and the offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
And it's first and 10. And a nice pass for a 10-yard gain.
It's not a first down in the stat line, but it's a first down in our hearts.
Second down, the size of Bricks Wiener. Sorry, partner. And a hard run there picks up the first down. Whoa, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. The offense is down to their last running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. And it's first and 10. Kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
First and 2. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
And it's first and ten. The receiver just got smashed.
Not as bad as me last night. He may be dead, but trust me, he's in better shape than I am right now. Oh, geez, here it goes. Blah.
Second down and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
First and ten. He's not going down. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done.
Give me a bacon, Billy.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten. And like every one of my barbecues, this guy's on fire. Does he like a rip? Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
This one just has some bullets time.
The offense lost their final running back. Lucky for them, they're on defense now.
Yeah, lucky to survive so much bad luck, carnage, and death, Grim.
And it's first and ten. And that's an incomplete pass. Looks like the defense got away with that one there.
They allowed to grab the receiver like that. He could get hurt.
Second down and ten. And he just wrestles away from that tackle. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and ten. Oh, great throw! Great catch! And that puts 6 points on the board!
The defense can do anything to stop a throw that good, man!
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And it's first and 10. That run is good for 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and 1. And the QB might as well just bury himself now, because this guy, and there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about sharing when he was in school.
Yeah, that's right.
He could go all the way. And it's first and 10. You can tell he's a berserker because he's from. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. This guy likes to play with soft balls. He's gonna play with crushed balls from here on out. Second down in a very lot. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
Third down and long.
Oh, man, he really wants it.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Unstoppable force meets the explodable object. And it's first and 10. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Why are they stopping the clock for the offense, Grim?
They're stopping it for their own offense. They're hungry for the ball, partner.
The ball? The pigskin? Bacon! I'm hungry for bacon!
Ah, another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else combined, you'd expect him not to play like total shit.
Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
You should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And another interception. This boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
And it's first and 10. Give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And the D takes their second time out, hoping for a miracle.
I witnessed a miracle once. A player was brought back from the dead.
That's not a miracle, partner. That's just how the MFL works.
Ah,
defense calls its final timeout.
Good. I gotta run to the John. That means I gotta deal with that grubby little bathroom attendant again. Always pushing his lifesavers, dirty comb, hairspray, cheap cologne on me. Hey, I'm here to take a crap. Now get ready.
Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Third down, and the punter is warming up. The offense just burned the defense pretty hard on that one.
That is still edible, though. Just gotta scrape off the charred parts.
Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And kickers practice for this kind of kick every day. Pretty standard.
Nothing standard when you got bloodthirsty mutants on the defensive line.
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. At this rate, the QB is going to have more interceptions than completions. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. Put that one in the loss column. The Grim Bay Attackers lose the game.
And they lost me $50.
They battled hard, but still got their butts handed to them.
Gross. I hope there weren't any orc butts involved.
I kind of like orc butts, especially with some Dijon mustard and a smoked pickle relish. Now that's living.
Let's go down to the field and see what the game's MVP thinks of today's outcome. Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...